Amanda, for thousands of years, the Watchers have lived by one single set of rules. We observe, we record, and we stay the hell out of it.
Could you give me a break? That is such a guy thing. You have your rules and MacLeod has his.
Mac and I had a good friend, Charlie DeSalvo. And he is dead because I broke those rules. Ah, damn it! See? I bleed. I can get an infection and die.
You want to run some cold water on that?
On the surface, we may look alike. But underneath, we are two different species. It's right that Mac backed off. It's better this way.
Look, Joe, we're all different. Black, white, men, women, we all live in our own little worlds.
With me and Mac, it's different universes.
Then why are you both so hurt?
What do you mean by that?
I mention your name and he immediately changes the subject. I bring him up and you've spent 10 minutes telling me all the things you don't have in common.
Which is absolutely everything.
Hey, pal, you wouldn't have change for the meter, would you?
I took an oath. I have to live by it.
Oh, yeah? Well, let's just picture two gravestones, okay? One says, he lived by the rules. The other one says, he was a good friend. Now, which one do you want?
I guess you tried to get the Beatles back together, too.
Come on, Joe. Just talk to him, okay, for me, please?
I'll think about it.
Good. Because he's on his way over.
MacLeod. He's coming here.
Mm-hmm.
To see me.
Well, actually, I told him you had the night off.
You expect me to make the first move?
Would you please, for me, Joe? Please?
Thought you were some big shot fighter.
I was a contender. 76 and 17. 47 knockouts.
If I hadn't zapped him, he would have kicked your ass.
Yeah. See you later.
Okay, tough guy.
Duncan MacLeod, the Highlander. Born in 1592 in the Highlands of Scotland, and he is still alive. He is immortal. For 400 years, he's been a warrior. A lover. A wanderer. Constantly facing other immortals in combat to the death. The winner takes his enemy's head, and with it, his power. I am a Watcher, part of a secret society of men and women who observe and record, but never interfere. We know the truth about immortals. In the end, there can be only one. May it be Duncan MacLeod, the Highlander.
Let's get him inside.
You know, you didn't need to zap him. I could have taken him.
Yeah, sure. We could have taken him to a movie, man.
Hey, I took him on.
You were a big help.
And you're a pain in the ass. Come on, sweetie. Around.
Would you look at that? I didn't think he'd be your type.
He's not.
Some time together, we could have a magical evening.
You like me, don't you?
Come here.
I'm sorry. I'm such a klutz. I'm just gonna go to the ladies' room. Don't go away. I'm really sorry.
Not bad for an amateur.
What are you talking about? I think the glass in the lab was overkill. Way, way over the top. Are you a cop? Not in this life. My name's Amanda. Why don't you sit and have a drink with me? My date's late. Moving on.
Oh, yeah?
Without these? I've had centuries of practice. Now, why didn't you take his wallet? It's not about cash. What's that sound? I'm not a thief. Really? Why don't you sit and talk to me? Tell me all about it. Then could we have two drinks? Something fruity?
Who the hell is that guy? Late.
Colonel's never late. We're 13 minutes early.
What's the Colonel want him for anyhow?
You're not being paid to ask questions.
You're a real friendly guy, you know that?
Basically, I go to work, I do perm. Go to a club, go to sleep. It's the same thing every day. The only thing that changes are the blue-haired old ladies that sit in my chair.
So you steal because you're bored?
Oh, no, I did it for the rush. I mean, I just want to take the guy's finger for a little joy ride. You know what? I'll get back. Do you want some company? You want to come with me? Bitchin. What about your date?
Looks like you got stood up.
Yeah, well, you know, he's teaching at this university. He's probably arguing with some co-ed about a grade.
Yeah. Right.
Sorry, Joe.
Hey. Got a problem.
You ready?
Yeah, we're out of here.
Okay, I'll see you later.
I got Fenton in three.
Fenton's a bum.
Yeah, he took you out.
He got lucky.
He got lucky he didn't kill you.
Mm. You should have seen me in my prime.
I did. As I remember, it lasted all of 20 minutes.
If I'd have been 5 years younger, I'd have murdered him.
Give it up, will you?
Lasers or shatterproof glass or computerized locks, and what's the fun in that?
You've done this before.
Oh, a couple of times in my youth.
What is that thing?
This is a digital analyzer.
You carry it in your purse?
Doesn't everybody? Damn, I'm good.
I think we just moved from bitten to like grand theft. Can't believe I'm here.
But stop. You ready?
Ringside. How about you guys?
Yeah, right. Ringside at Gleason's bar. You think this bum would have comped me a couple of tickets?
You ever do any boxing?
Yeah, right.
Oh, did we actually do that?
I think so.
I mean, one minute I'm sitting in a bar, and the next I'm breaking into Lavelle's. This is outrageous. I mean, I do some crazy things sometimes, but this is just
fun.
Yeah. I mean, I bet you do this kind of stuff all the time.
I used to.
Not anymore?
Gave it up.
Why? Oh, no, wait. Don't tell me. It's for a guy, right? The one who stood you up tonight? Man's a fool, if you ask me.
He had a good reason.
Says him.
Any problems?
Nah, I took him down in two.
Place him in the car.
Yeah.
You didn't take him in two.
Shut up.
You couldn't take my mother in two.
What? watching you when we were breaking into Lavelle's. Your hands didn't shake. You didn't sweat. You just had this look on your face that said, no matter how hard they tried to keep you out, you knew they couldn't. Am I right?
Yes.
So what did you do before you were
a thief?
Yeah.
Mostly I was hungry. Duncan's here.
How can you tell?
The door.
Oh. Yeah.
Hey. Why don't you meet my new friend, Melissa? Melissa, this is Duncan MacLeod. His friends call him Mac.
Hi there.
Hi, Mac.
Hi.
He's awesome.
You're terrible.
She said I looked awesome.
She lied.
I think I better go.
Yeah. Okay, well, I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Okay, okay. Bye. It was nice meeting you, Mac.
Yeah, and you, Melissa.
Bye.
Well, you can tell me all about it in a hot bath, okay? Maybe I'll even join you.
Sorry about Joe's. A little business to take care of.
That's all right. We'll do it another time. So, what? Did the other guy have a bigger sword or something?
Don't worry about it, it's just an old war wound acting up.
What's his name?
Killian.
Will he keep coming?
He'll keep coming. He's got to have reason.
Simon Killian, commanding.
Duncan MacLeod, transporting the wounded.
Ambulance driver?
That's correct.
I would think that a man of your experience could do better.
I chose this duty.
Why? When you could lead men into battle instead. Share their glory, hear their shouts of victory.
And the screams of the maimed and dying. I fought here against Napoleon and Louis XIV. I've seen men die for the same ground too many times to want to do it again.
The artillery's in place, Colonel.
Excellent, Sergeant. Thank you. The Hun think that they own this ground, but we own it. We paid for it with the blood of 1,000 men.
Excuse me, sir. For your canteen, thank you.
Urgent, sir.
Now that I have the reinforcements, I will drive them all the way back to Berlin.
Urgent, sir. From headquarters.
Thank you. That'll be all. On your whistle, Sergeant. Tell the men.
Yes, sir.
Today we take our revenge.
Sergeant, wait! You can't do this.
We have left too many dead here to leave with nothing.
But the war is over. No one else has to die.
They die if I tell them to die. Put him in irons.
It's true. Save yourself.
Oh, my God. It is over.
What? I did not receive this. Do you understand? This never arrived.
You can't do this, Killian. The war is over.
The war is over when we take that ground. Sound the attack, Sergeant. That is an order.
I'm sorry, sir. But there won't be any attack. I'll tell the men the news.
Sergeant!
No!
Colonel Killian. After careful consideration of the evidence, this court finds you guilty on all charges. Your heinous act resulted in the unnecessary deaths of 300 British and German soldiers. You are hereby stripped of all rank and privileges and sentenced to death by firing squad. And God only will have mercy on your soul.
You think you judge me? You think you can dispose of me that easily? Men and their governments come and go, playing at peace, while soldiers like me fight on. Read your history books. Peace is nothing but a pause between the wars. Do you not think we will fight Germany again?
Guards, restrain him.
Shoot me if you will. I am Colonel Simon Killian. I was Colonel Simon Killian before you were born. I will be Colonel Simon Killian long after you and yours are dead. I will dance on your graves, you insignificant bastards!
Your testimony is on record. What more can you add?
I fear a grave injustice will be done if I do not speak. Please, I beg the court's indulgence. I am a simple man. But I was there when he ordered those men into battle. And I can attest he was not in right mind. He is as he was then, a victim of his own delusions. I beg you, show mercy. Spare his life.
You bastard. I know what you're doing. I demand to be shot. Do you hear me? It is my right. I demand it. Do you hear me?
He was sentenced to life in a prison for the criminally insane.
Why didn't you just let them shoot him?
He had to pay the price for the men he killed. Amanda, his crime was committed in the mortal world. It was only right that he was sentenced by mortal justice.
Sometimes I worry about your overindulged sense of morality.
Do you now?
Yeah. But I wouldn't worry. I'll protect you from it.
It's just lunch. Besides, once you get to know her, I think you're really gonna like her.
Amanda, you only met her last night.
What can I say? There's something about a woman with her hand on a man's wallet that just turns me on. Besides, what's the worst thing that can happen?
She could be arrested. She could go to prison.
No. I'm a pro.
She's not.
Would you not worry? I promise we'll be good.
Yeah. I'm sure you won't be dressed like that.
What's wrong with the way I'm dressed?
Oh, nothing.
You know, I think I'm taller than you are.
Yeah, very funny.
Oh, here's a place.
No, you look just fine like that.
Oh, fine lines, girlfriend.
You like it?
Yeah.
Where?
For me?
Yeah, why not?
I couldn't.
All right, I'll keep it.
Oh, on second thought. Oh, that's very nice. Thank you. You're the best.
Oh, it's so good. Oh, so sweet.
Just like sisters.
What do you think?
I think one of you's enough.
Colonel.
Consider the lone arachnid, Sergeant.
Sir?
For years, they were my only companions. Bees have a complex social structure. Ants are arranged by class into an efficient army of workers. But I prefer spiders. Each so unique. Solitary, spinning their fragile webs alone. This one is a tarantula. A harmless pet. That one, Loxicellus reclusa, is as deadly as a bullet under the right circumstances. Rather like people. Some are poisonous. Some are harmless. What do you have for me? The perfect bait. Does he know it for a work of art, I wonder? Or does he know it only for the satisfaction of seeing his prey entangled in the merciless strands?
Here she comes.
What can I do? Remove her blindfold. Very pretty. But not as pretty as this.
What do you want from me?
I want nothing from you. I want MacLeod. He'll be coming to save you.
Why would he save me?
Because he loves you.
Loves me? I just met him yesterday.
You lie rather well for someone so ordinary.
I swear it's the truth.
Tell me this isn't you.
It's not. That's Amanda. His girlfriend.
You're lying.
I swear I'm not. Oh, God. Get it off me. Get it off me. Get it off.
The truth.
I told you the truth. I'm a nobody.
You know, I think you are.
Duncan?
MacLeod. What?
Melissa's going to be here in a minute. Would you entertain her while I get ready, please?
What are you going to teach your little protege tonight? How to knock off an armored truck?
No, you know, I thought we'd go down to Kentucky and try Fort Knox. Would you give me a break? We're just going to a club. She knows the band.
I'm sure she does. Are you enjoying this?
What? A girl's got to have friends of her own.
Same hair, same clothes. Don't you find it a little odd being cloned?
Well, you know, I can't help it that the girl has excellent taste. As long as she doesn't have my man.
One of you is all I could handle.
Oh. I gotta get ready. So you have to handle me later.
I can't wait. Downstairs. Stay here.
Right.
It's okay, Melissa. It's all right. Don't move. Stay still. Okay. Come on, Melissa. Please.
It hurts. Help me. Please don't leave me here.
God.
I won't leave you. Take care of her. Call an ambulance.
Oh, my God. What did you do to her? Oh, honey. Come on. It's good. Okay. It's going to be okay. I'm so cold.
hold him, Amanda. It's okay. It's okay. He's the one that's you. That's pretty good, huh? I just wanted to have some fun.
Welcome to my parlor.
Very homey. If you wanted me here, you should have just told me instead of using the girl.
Think of her as an invitation.
This is between you and me, Killian. Isn't that what you dreamed of all these years?
My dreams would terrify you. Kill him!
Liver.
Lovely piece of work. How do you feel, MacLeod? Naked? Helpless, just as I felt when they took my rank and my sword.
You deserved it.
Did I? You know, you were right. I have dreamed of this day. 70 years. 70 years they locked me away. So long that no one remembered where I came from or who I was. All I thought about was you.
Really?
And how to return the favor.
Oh, I'm flattered.
Get used to your new home, MacLeod. No one's used this brig in 40 years, and the only one who knows you're down here thinks you're dead.
So what's my sentence, Colonel, sir?
Fair is fair. I did 70 years, you'll do 70 years. Unless, of course, someone takes my head. Then you'll be here forever.
Maybe I should take up a hobby.
There's enough food and water here for the first 50 years. Long enough for everything you love to die. And so you don't think too badly of me. The light bulb is an extended life. It should burn for at least 2 years. I've heard that the madness comes more slowly in the light. And I want you to experience every precious moment as you wait for the darkness to come.
I guess you didn't leave me anything to read.
Just the walls and the ceiling, MacLeod.
Amanda. Two immortals go off together, one doesn't come back. We both know what happened. I'm sorry.
Look, Joe, I would know if he was dead. I would feel it.
Amanda. He's gone.
No, he's alive. And if he's not alive, then I want to know where to find Killian.
All right. I'll see what I can find out.
If I came down the stage, even when I want to.
Joe Dawson? Andrea Henson. I watch Simon Killian.
Thanks for coming down. Can I get you coffee?
Sure. Is there a problem?
No. No problem. I'm sure you're doing just fine.
I'm still filing with London. We figure Killian will go back there.
Yeah, you're probably right. Do you think Killian came to town just for MacLeod?
Stands to reason they got a history.
You know, they met last night. I'm writing my clothes up on MacLeod.
He's not dead. They shot him, but Killian didn't take his head. He's locked him in one of those old cells at the abandoned Air Force base. You didn't know?
No, I didn't know.
Listen, this is your territory, and I'm the new kid on the block. But I know people in the Paris office, and a gal hears stuff, rumors.
What kind of rumors?
You and MacLeod. That you're more than just his watcher. You're not gonna get involved, are you, Joe?
I thought we agreed to stay out of each other's way.
But we can always throw you back if you want.
I'm gonna take a trip to Gleason's bar.
You're drunk!
It was him, I tell you, at Gleason's bar. He was no more than 30 feet away from me.
That's impossible!
Oh, what's impossible is he's alive. I put 7 slugs in that guy.
Did you check the cell?
No.
Thank you.
did you?
I used to be in the Boy Scouts.
Got a merit badge just for this.
Amanda, it wasn't your fault.
Oh, yeah, well, whose fault was it, huh? She was trying to be like me. She almost died. And I just let her do this.
It was Killian's fault, not yours.
I know, but it doesn't feel that way. I don't know what to tell you. Look. I love you, and you're my best friend. But just have to go away. I've got to get it together.
Door's always open.
I know. God, I forgot how fragile they are.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to call you when I get there, and you can send my stuff to me.
Anything you need, anything I can do, I'll always be there for you, all right?
Thank you.
You want to take five, Lou?
You broke the rules.
Yeah, well, it's not the first time. Figured it was a good cause. It's hard to say no to Amanda.
Yeah, I know. She left this morning.
Well, you'll see her again.
Always do.
You want to talk about it?